So vapor pressure of chloroform CHCl3 and dichlorometer CH2Cl2 at 298 Kelvin are 200 mercuric pressure and 450 mercuric pressure respectively. Okay, in the sense first one is the value of this and the second one is the value of that chlorometer. You are supposed to calculate the vapor pressure of the solution prepared by mixing of 25.5 gram of chloroform as well as 40 gram of dichlorometer at 298 Kelvin. And the second question, it goes like mole fraction of each component in vapor phase you are supposed to find. Vapor phase in the sense it goes with y. Okay, so you are supposed to find here. So first we will find out the vapor pressure of the solution. The formula, it goes like this: P total is equal to P1 naught plus, it is not P1 naught minus P2 because greater it comes first, so it goes like P2 naught minus P1. Okay, just make proper with the formula whatever I have given last. Okay, so it goes into multiplication with extra. So because based on that only I have changed the sign also. So here the concept when we will be discussing, P1 naught is nothing but the partial vapor pressure of a pure component, or P1 in this is first component. So it comes as 200 plus P2 naught is nothing but 415 minus of again P1 naught is 200 into mole fraction. In the sense x2 I need to find it. So I don't know x2. Okay. So x2 in the sense mole fraction of the second component, it is nothing but dichlorometer. But I find for the first, I mean both the components, because it will be easy to find the next one. Okay. So like mole fraction of chloroform. Okay, when you are finding, formula comes as number of moles of the particular component divided by total number of the moles. But number of moles they did not give, so that you are supposed to find it out. First find out the number of mole of CHCl3, okay, chloroform. Number of mole is nothing but the formula goes like mass by molar mass. Mass of chloroform divided by molar mass of chloroform. So what is the mass of chloroform that they have given as in? Mixing with the 25.5 gram and 5 gram of chloroform. So you can take mass as 25.5 and molar mass carbon 12, hydrogen 1 and chlorine 35.5. So add it and you will get 119.5. So the answer will be 0.213 gram per mole. So that is the number of moles of this. Okay. Because you want total number of moles, you can find with another also, in the sense number of moles of dichloromethane. So dichloromethane in the sense when you are finding, you know, mole fraction when you are finding, it goes like mass by molar mass again. So mass of the substance that they have given as 40 gram, 40 by again find the molar mass. So that goes like carbon 12, hydrogen 1 into 2, chlorine 35.5 into 2, so that it comes with 85. Okay, so the answer you will get with 0.47 gram per mole. Okay, so that is the concept in the sense, I mean answer whatever we get it over here, and that one we are supposed to substitute over here. Okay, mole fraction of chloroform is nothing but number of moles of particular component. So number of moles of particular component is nothing but 0.213. Okay, divided by total number of the, I mean number of particles, in the sense 0.213 plus 0.417. 0.213 plus 0.47. So just substitute, calculate, so that you will get it as 0.312. So mole fraction of your chloroform, you will get it as 0.312. Now find it out the mole fraction of another component, that is dichloromethane CH2Cl2, which is nothing but X2. Okay, so how we can find it out? 1 minus X1. X1 is nothing but 0.312, so that you will get 0.688. Okay, so now this one you substitute over here, 0.688, because X2 is nothing but 0.688. So that substitute and find the answer, it will get it as 347.9 mmHg, because you are finding total pressure. Okay, in total pressure you are going to find out, so you are supposed to write in terms of mercuric pressure. And next question, it goes like mole fraction of each component in vapor phase. In vapor phase in the sense, the formula it goes like yi is nothing but pi by p total. You know what is